This discussion will focus on non-ambulatory animals or downers and euthanasia. There are several reasons for non-ambulatory or downer animals, and they typically include injury, disease, or nutritionally related disorders. A prompt diagnosis should be made to determine if the animal will respond to treatment and care, or whether the animal should be euthanized. Care and well-being is a responsibility of livestock owners and caretakers who must make every effort to provide proper care, treatment, and an environment that's conducive for the animal to thrive. These animals cannot be sent to a local market or to a processing facility if they're non-ambulatory. Euthanasia, by definition, is a humane death without pain and suffering. The person performing the procedure should be knowledgeable of the available methods and have the necessary skill to safely perform humane euthanasia. The veterinarian has both the knowledge and the skills necessary. Sometimes, however, the animal's well-being requires immediate euthanasia when the veterinarian is not immediately available. In this case, the producer may need to perform on-farm euthanasia. It is essential that the producer possess both the knowledge and the skill needed for humane euthanasia before proceeding. Calves require special consideration in selecting the proper method of euthanasia. Ethical considerations do not change the need for calves because they are small or more easily handled. Calves can be easily euthanized with a penetrating captive bolt gun or an overdose of barbiturates. When using barbiturates, make sure all legal restrictions are followed. Bulls require special considerations as well because of their size, attitude, and physical thickness of their skulls. Operator safety is a primary concern when euthanizing bulls. For certain techniques, proper restraint is going to be critical and required. Bulls may be euthanized with a barbiturate overdose, a specialized heavy-duty captive bolt gun, or with a 9mm shot using a firearm. The use of firearms or captive bolt requires skill and training. Persons using a firearm must understand the possibility of ricochet and the possibility of injury to those that are present. Responsible individuals must be knowledgeable and appropriately trained before proceeding. The correct location for using a captive bolt or a firearm shot is in a square, in the intersection of a square between the horns and the eyes in a cross fashion. The reason for this cross between the horn and the eye of the opposite side is that you're trying to hit the brain, and the brain is located in the center of the forehead and not between the eyes. Ethical and humane standards of euthanasia do not allow the following methods of euthanasia in the bovine. Number one, using a manually applied blunt trauma to the head. Also not approved is the injection of chemical agents into a conscious animal, using such things as disinfectants, electrolytes such as potassium chloride or magnesium sulfate, or other non-anesthetic pharmaceutical agents. Also not approved for use is air embolism, and also unacceptable is electrocution with 112-volt electrical cord. Use proper methods of carcass disposal once an animal is put down in accordance with state, federal, and local regulations. These need to be followed to the letter. If utilizing a rendering service, keep deceased livestock in a screened area away from public view, but close to the farm entrance to maintain biosecurity. You do not want any materials or fluids leaking from the rendering truck that might cause disease introduction into your operation.